For more on all this, let's bring in Judge Andrew Napolitano, Fox News senior judicial analyst. Good morning to you, Judge.
Good morning.
What strikes you this morning as we learned he turned himself in, and now we are about to get an update from the police?
A couple of observations. I'm wondering if he really did this, and the evidence points that way, what he told his lawyers, because his lawyers put on the public face of he didn't do it, and the truth is going to come out. If he had been truthful to his lawyers, they had an opportunity to negotiate a deal for him, in my view, a small window of time about 6 or 7 days ago during which they could have negotiated, I think, some sort of a guilty plea without incarceration. But now it's gone too far. His persistence in lies, it appears, restated by the lawyers, digging their heels in, causing the Chicago police, you'll probably hear soon how much money they spent on this, spent a fortune in person, power, and in resources, have closed the window during which he could make a deal. The other interesting issue is there's another prosecution here that may happen, the federal government. If he mailed that threatening letter to himself, by using the post office, he engaged in postal fraud. That's 5 to 10 years in jail. That's three times what he's facing for filing a false report with the Chicago.
That's the more serious matter here to be addressed.
Yes, if the feds want to go there.
So we'll hear from police in a moment. What happens this afternoon?
Well, this afternoon, I think he will plead not guilty and be released either on his own recognizance or with a very small bail. I don't think he's a threat to society. As far as I know, he doesn't have any prior record. They may ask him to surrender his passport just to be sure that he can't leave the country.
So this afternoon is a plea and it is posting bond.
Correct. If there is bond, I mean, it could be a simple signature, a simple promise to return. Since it's a public person, it's hard for him to go anywhere without anybody knowing.
We do know that he did speak to police several times leading up to this. Most recently, his invites, he didn't show. We know that. But he did speak to police. He also spoke in several interviews. He maintained his story throughout. Can those words be used against him?
Yes, Sandra. This is a very, very important question you have just asked. Each time he lied is a separate and distinct offense if the prosecutors want to frame it that way. Filing the false report is an offense. Lying to them to back it up first time he met with them is a second offense. Lying to them to back it up the second time he met with them. So sometimes they merge those into one charge, but if they really want to get aggressive with him, they will file and get the grand jury to approve several charges against them, which expands his exposure in jail and gives the police more negotiating latitude with his lawyers.
I'm going to get to Daniel Linsky in a moment here, but just characterize this for us, Judge. When you think about the national attention a story like this brought to the case, when you think about the charge of racism that involved all the politics that was thrown into it, does the judge weigh those factors? Given the amount of national...
I hope not. It sickened me that the president was drawn into this, that the MAGA stuff was drawn into it, that a lot of people said, look, we're a racist society. This is an example of it. People who jumped the gun.
You said you hope not. I'm asking, does the judge have to consider some of this in the case now?
Under the law, the judge sentences the defendant and the crime and not the events around him. So I don't think the judge will take that into consideration.
Okay. You think about the amount of crime that the city of Chicago faces and the amount of resources that were taken away and poured into this investigation for a month, Judge.
I mean, that's the harm that he caused to the government, and that's a very legitimate argument for them pursuing him aggressively.